thank you, you maybe sister, thank you. Hallelujah. Viewers all over the world, thank you for your time. And I can't imagine where you would have been if not this meeting here today. And I know you're at home watching Emmanuel TV instead of going somewhere I don't want to mention. Thank you for disappointing them. Not only the viewer, you too, I want to say thank you for disappointing them. Well, you have a lot of appointment. Tell your neighbor you have a lot of appointment. I don't want to mention them. Thank you for disappointing them. Hallelujah. In every disappointment, there's appointment. You are here having an appointment with God. Yes, last week, I think the Lord still given us the same method, the same way and manner. I was here last week, Saturday, and after my exercise, I left, and the wise men came in. And that really helped the next Sunday, so we want God giving us that breakthrough, that tomorrow's service will be a great relief if they start their job today, because yes, if they start their job today, tomorrow there will be a great relief, because after my meeting with you, I will leave and the wise men will come begin their job today. Yes, it's very important. Like we all know today, the crisis we are facing all over in the Christendom, we confess born again without deliverance. We only believe when you come out to say, Jesus is my Lord, my Savior, I'm redeemed, He's died for me, rise again, this, that. And we have failed to realize that a man may confess Jesus is Lord and not such in heart. And I mean, a man may confess Jesus is Savior is Lord and not such in word and not such in heart. So to now such in heart, nothing can make it such in heart without deliverance. It is only deliverance that can touch your heart. Every other thing, just by. So, to be such in heart, you need deliverance. You may love a job, but not such in heart. You may love a friend, not such in heart. You may love certain things, not such in heart. You may even love your nation, not such in heart. That many things you love, not such in heart. Many. You say, oh, I love you, I love my country, I love my this, I love that, I love my job. Even the job you are doing now, you may love it, you may love the job, but not such in heart. Your wife, not such in heart. Your husband, not such in heart. A lot of things going on in this world. Unless that love such in heart, eat your heart, enter your heart, that is when we can say love of God. There are two love now. Love for selfish reason, for materialism, and for classic reason. It's a different love. This is love conditional. But love such in heart, unconditional love. That is love of Christ, searching heart. Tell your neighbor, searching heart. I can't hear you. 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 If you love your job, searching heart, no matter what happened to you, no matter failure, no matter crisis, the passion to do it will still be there. The money you make cannot influence you, does not determine the love you have for your business. You may make $1 billion every day, but not such in heart. Not such in heart, the love. Take note of that. So also when you say I'm a Christian, I'm born again, I'm being a bishop, I'm a pastor, I'm a prophet, whatever name you call yourself, I'm not such in heart. So can you see where your situation, your problem is coming from? Just not such in heart. Your husband, I love my wife so much, I love my husband. Such, not such in heart. I love my job, I love my business. Not such in heart. But it expressed the same way on the outside, on the surface, but different in the deep. You express it the same way. The same way, the same manner, people will say, hey, ha. Hey, love, no, yes, he confesses it. Look at it, even. But in the deep. When you love your business, such in heart, you will do that business because of good name, not because of money. You want to maintain that good name. Anything that will tarnish your name or affect your name, you try to avoid it. But not to make, not the issue of making trillion or billion of dollars. But that name is so precious, greater than anything. No amount of money can buy it. It's not for sale. That name. But today what has happened? We do business because of money. And if we are not making money, we begin to complain that this is not of God. This is not a destined job. When the failure comes, we begin to count how many failures. But you are afraid to count how many success you made. This has affected us greatly. And we have carried this attitude towards God, relationship. The same attitude we have carried to our faith. That when you, Jesus healed me, and Jesus is not healed you, is not love you, is not faithful to you, you are not a Christian. Because your love to Christ is not such in heart. Then you say, Jesus, give me bread, in Jesus' name, give me, and you are not receiving it in time, you begin to see Jesus in a bad light. Your passion for him, your love for him, begin to withdraw gradually. You pray less, you fast less. You determine your relationship with God by a number of prayer that answer. That is how you determine your relationship. And people call you Christian because your prayer answer. When you have a breakthrough, they say, oh, he's a Christian. That is why he has a breakthrough. Oh, he's a Christian. Yes, he's a Christian. you come out to confess Jesus openly because of the blessing you have received so much. The breakthrough determines the kind of attire to wear to the service. Breakthrough determine what? Answer to your prayer determine the kind of attire you wear tomorrow. Your dress, your suit. If you have a huge breakthrough, the best attire you wear tomorrow. And when it is tomorrow, you dance more than anybody. People can now begin to say, why is he dancing like this? Move close to him. He will tell you, I have testimony. So the love we have nowadays are not such in heart. This is why our life is like this. Your love towards your job are not such in heart. Your love towards Christ are not such in heart. And faith is of man's spirit, not of man's flesh or body. And only faith pleases God. How will you please him? How can you please him when your love towards him are not such in heart? How can you please him? Because faith is of man's spirit, man's heart. How can you please God? It means whatever you are doing, your humility, if your humility are not such in heart, are not for Christ. If your simplicity are not such in heart, are not for Christ. If your faithfulness are not such in heart, are not for Christ. If your goodness are not such in heart, are not for Christ. If your gentleness, your faithfulness, your goodness are not such in heart, are not for Christ. It means all this faithfulness, kindness, so I'll be faithful to Christ, I'll be very kind, I've stopped this, I've stopped that, I've not been lying, I've not been this, I've not been doing that, but still my prayer is not answered. Because those things are not such in heart. No, I have been, since I become a Christian, I've keep off from friends, I've been very keep to myself, reading my Bible, prayer, fast and prayer. I've not been going to club, nightclub. No, I've been keeping off from all those things I used to do in the past. But what else again do I need to do? If you are doing all this and not such in heart, they are not for Christ. Because our heart is a communication point. Can you say why you are still like that? I've been faithful, I've not been lying. I've not been telling lies. But you have not been telling lies. But there's hurt to say to lie. I've not been telling lies, but you have hurt to lie. I've not been smoking, I've stopped smoking. But anytime you see cigarette, there is hurt to smoke. You are not such in heart. Are you with me? I've been very careful. I used to be very arrogant. People come to me and say, hi. But now I greet people, I laugh. But each time you want to be humble, you want to exercise humility, that pride will, the heart to be proud is there. You say, I don't want to be proud. That in me, your humility are not such in heart. And whatever that are not such in heart are not for who? Talk to me. Amen. God is spirit, and his worshiper must worship him in what? God is spirit, and his worshiper must be faithful in. God is spirit, his worshiper must be kindness in, goodness in, gentleness in, because faith is of spirit, of man's spirit. So can you see our quick judgment each time you see people, this man used to go to church, he sleep in the church, he's always in the church 24 hours, he's an elder in the church, he coordinated the church, he cleaned the church, he worshiped, he cleaned everything, church, you go home, you see he's in the church, he fasts, he pray, but there's nothing to show, really. You can't, you just look at him and say, why all this? You can't ask him, are you a Christian because of the... In me, all what he's doing are not such in heart. Come on. If I want to pray for this gentleman, and I hold you as a pastor or prophet, I begin to say, in the name of Jesus, be healed, be delivered. If all what I'm saying are not such in heart, I'm talking of myself. What do I mean by talking of myself, standing my brother? I mean, I will only hear myself. People around me will hear me, but God will not hear me. This is what happened to seven sons of Sceva. It's an opportunity for Satan, for demon to strike. Sometimes we tempt them. That is, I'm tempting now. If I begin to say, in the name of Jesus, be healed, be delivered, and all this I'm saying, I'm not searching hard. I'm tempting devil to tempt me. Very, very. I'm tempting devil, because devil doesn't want to hear the name Jesus. When they hear the name Jesus, who is calling the name? Who is calling the name? Who is calling the name? They want to know whether what he say are such in heart. If not, they'll attack him. So many of you, instead of you to sit quietly, you keep tempting the devil to tempt you. If what you are doing are not such in heart, you are wasting your time. You are tempting Satan to tempt you. God is spirit, and his worshiper must do so in what? God is spirit, and his worshiper must exercise their love towards him in spirit. The fruit of the spirit. They are not saying the fruit of this flesh. Did you read it in the Galatia? That the fruit of the flesh, there is fruit of this flesh. Because they say killing, stealing, destruction, that is why you believe you are not exercising the fruit of this flesh. There is an heart out of obedience. Satan to act to be obedient. Out of faithfulness, Satan to used to act as faithful person. Out of holiness, Satan used to also act as holiness. They can act it. By acting it, is by doing it, not such in heart, out of spirit of God. The day you will know that the name you call yourself, Christian, Ada, you are a pastor, you are there, you will realize that God does not even know you. It's not aware of what you are doing. It will be very, very painful to you. Ignorance is what has happened to many of us. You are waiting to hear from Jesus direct that look, I don't know you. Your faithfulness is not to me. Your kindness is not towards me. Your goodness is not towards me. You say you're a Christian, you are just wasting your time. You want to hear directly, direct from God. No. How can you hear direct from God when your act of Christian is not of God? When you don't know whether you're a Christian or not, definitely how will you know that God is hearing you? This is ignorance. The whole world today, we are upside down. 99, if not 90% of Christians, they don't know whether they are Christian or not. There are many questions they ask themselves. Am I a Christian? Why this? Why that? If I'm a Christian, why this? Why that? If I'm a Christian, why can't I talk to God and God talk to me? Why can't I hear from Him and He hear to hear me from me? That is the challenge. If I'm a Christian, why can't I hear from Him and let Him hear from me? I want to hear the vision. I want to see vision. I want to see revelation. I want to see it. There are many questions unanswered. But I want to leave you here. Once again, love are not such in hearts. Kindness are not such in hearts. Goodness are not such in hearts. That is why today you see humanitarian services, humanitarian all over the world, people can put $1 trillion for the sake of humanitarian services, but not a believer. He will say, I don't believe God, there is no God, but he will put billion down to support the world. What can you say about that? So it means there are laws that are not searching hearts. Gesture, good gesture. A giver that are not such a heart. Put $1 trillion down. Say, hey, it's for God to care for the needy and other. But you say they don't believe God. They are not given this the name of God because they don't believe God. So what do you want to say? How can you differentiate this from you that a Christian? Huh? You that a Christian, how can we differentiate this from you that truly a Christian? In the same way you give yours, in the same way they give their own. Even sometimes they give huge one, bigger than yours. So now how will you differentiate this from your own? This is to tell you that love and not searching heart are not love of God. So prayer and not searching heart, and not pray to God. Heart, like I have told you, when you hear heart in your Bible from Genesis to Revelation, you refer to spirit. Spirit means heart. So which is quite different from your study. When I refer to heart, I mean spirit. Say, faith is of man's heart. I mean faith is of man's spirit. Because the God's will has a capacity to develop a spiritual force within our hearts called faith. Because the Bible says, the word I speak to you is spirit and life. The word I speak to you is what?
Spirit.
Okay, it means God's word is spirit. If God's word is spirit, it means it has, it can cook in us. So, capacity to develop a spiritual force within heart. Not the word I speak to you is flesh, but the word I speak is spirit. So me, love of must be spirit. Meaning there is a force. When you speak, if there is no force in what you are saying, it go nowhere. That is why we say spirit of love, spirit of faithfulness, spirit of kindness, spirit of goodness, self-control, spirit. Because the Bible says the word I speak is not is of spirit, not of flesh. If what I'm about to do now are not of spirit, it go nowhere. I will speak of myself. There must be a conversion. Conversion. That's to stand your genuine willingness. The reason why you are talking will determine the force. When you say, let there be light. The question, whom are you speaking on behalf? Because God, Satan, let there be light, now depend on whom you are ambassador for. Whom you are acting for. Let there be light. Be he. Depend Satan, God, then whom send you will determine the action. If I'm talking to you as a prophet, I'm prophesying to you when I say, hey, yes, this is this. This is that. It depends on whom sent me will determine. So when a prophet is speaking, talking to you, you can know if God sent him. If you are not in the dark, if a prophet speaks, you can know if God sent him. Take notes. Because they are communicator between visible and invisible, material world and immaterial. To be a communicator, speaking on behalf. God has no tongue but our tongue. He has no hand but our hand to heal. So, thank you. Are you ready?
Yeah.
if you are ready, it is not all of God. You have a role to play. Your genuine willingness plus God's ability will bring breakthrough. Your genuine what? Your genuine willingness must be searched in heart. Your coming here must be searched in heart. Your sitting must be searched in heart. Your looking must be searched in heart. Your smile must be searching heart. Must be searching heart. Searching heart. And you cannot pretend to be searching heart. It is not possible. You can pretend to confess, I'm pastor, but it's not possible to be searching heart by pretense. Are you with me? Because God's word renews, refreshes our mind, God's word. But His Spirit renews our strength. There are two, God's word, God's Spirit. His power, that is what I'm saying, God's word refreshes our mind. God's Spirit renews our strength. I mean, God's power working through His word and His Spirit. There are two, His word, His Spirit. God's power must work through them. His word first, His Spirit. Now, come, brother, come. Stand here. Here. Stand here. Okay. Look at me. Just look at me. Now, this is God's will. Stand here. This is God's will. This is God's Spirit. This is born again. Come, brother. Come. Stand here. This is born again. Before this man can be born again and become a renewer, apostle, a child of God, a privilege to be a partaker of divine sin, of divine holiness. Something must pass here. This is God's power now. It must move through His word and His Spirit to deliver this man. Take note again. This is God's will. This is God's power. The gospel must move. If this will is genuine, it's of heart. The one that speak the will is of heart. Speak by His Spirit. It will go through this. I said this one. Once this is genuine, this one is genuine. This God's Spirit, and give back to this what you want to become. That is to give back to apostle, to give back to born again, to give back to Christian, whatever name. This is the processing. God processing must move. God's power working through His word and His Spirit to deliver war, to give back to this. So now the challenge we are having now today is here. Not even here, because you can't reach there if here is not genuine. The challenge we are having today is here. Because you cannot even smile here at all if this one is not genuine. The challenge here now is we want to study this way, like the way, in the same way we study history. You want to graduate in this way, the same way you graduate in pharmacy. you want to graduate in this way, in the same way you study in the Bible, I mean, you study the history, the philosophy, whatever book, in your academic. This is the way we want to study. And people keep studying this way, just study and sit for exam and pass it and have degree, some have PhD, doctorate degree, and what degree, whatever name you call them. Everybody wants to study this way. But no, we must study. There's nothing bad about it. But we must know that this world, we must be carried along by the Holy Spirit. If you are not carried along, this world cannot be integral part. If this world is not integral part, you can't mind this place. For the world to be integral part, it must not only be memorized, it must be received by our heart. Not only to commit it into memory, but also to receive it to our heart. So this is where the challenge comes from now. This is where you see people blow grammar, blow Bible. They can quote Bible from Genesis to Revelation. The Bible we have today, if you put them different Bible together, up to 10, 9 of this publisher of this book, they are not Christians, they are philosophers. They read it, they studied it, and they published the Bible. Not for Christ's sake, but for money, for selfish, for classic reason. Many authors of this Bible you have today, they are not Christian. So now, people don't smile in here. Because once you pass through here and here, you begin to act for God, act with Him, engage in His projects. He has many projects. One of His projects is healing. One of His projects is deliverance. One of His projects is prophecy. One of His projects is breakthrough. God project. God, tell your neighbor, God has a lot, many projects. One of His projects is healing. He will use you to heal the nation. He will use you to heal people. He will use you to deliver. One of His projects is healing. One of His projects is deliverance. One of His projects is to bless people. One of the projects is to see visions to nation. It's not our project. It is never our project. It's God's project. But you can only act or deliver this project act on God's behalf of God when you pass through this and through here. This act together, we call it our way. I mean, word and our spirit act upon. I mean, God's word and spirit act upon. So, can you see? So this is why now. So thank you, brother. You may be seated. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. If you hear me clearly, let us say your hand. And you are now realizing where your problem come from. There's nothing bad. Study the word of God. Going to theology school. There's nothing bad about that. But we must know that not only to commit the word into memory. You know, our academic, your degree, you commit everything in memory. First degree, you commit it. When you are going for second degree, you have to carry those books and throw it somewhere, because you don't want to remember it, because it will stand hinder you. It will be too much for you to continue to remember your first degree while you are studying the second degree. It will be too much for you. Just like you have 20 cars, you can't memorize all those numbers of your cars. The one you are using presently, you have on your head, or you have. Rise up. Thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you. Give thanks to him. Give thanks to him. The Lord is good. Give thanks to him. Hallelujah. Give thanks to God. Let your tongue be searching heart. In Jesus Christ's name. And that for one tongue to be searching heart, you should not give thanks to God. You know, we normally give thanks to God when miracle happen. We give thanks to God for immediate miracle. But when you are still complaining, pain, it's difficult for a human being to say, thank you, Jesus. Even at home, you want to pray and you have a pain, serious pain, and you want to pray. The first thing you start saying, you are worthy. You start song. You have a way of approaching God. Give me. And Satan know all this. You know, give me. If that is the case, and it's not right. If that is the case, it will now be you say your situation as a bait. Your situation as what? A bait. Satan want to come and tempt you. Look at what is the situation of this man? Yes. He had problem with the wife. Aha. Good. Problem with the wife. He will now begin to send an errand, Satan errands, to come and give you news. Look, your wife, we saw your wife opposite, very close to one hotel. But we are still monitoring her to know whether she used to go to hotel. You say, I said it. That is why he's fighting me. Another one, they will come again. They can call you on phone. They will look for your number, text a number to you. We have got it. It's right. It's going there. So can you imagine all sort of Satan will use your weakness, your situation as a bait of getting you. If it is a vehicle that has fault, a Porsche car you normally use to bring your family home to the church, and suddenly you have fought with this vehicle, Satan will begin to talk to you that, you know, you are too big to join public vehicle to church. You know that? So people will not respect you. Why can't you wait and let your vehicle get okay? It's true. You tell your wife, my wife, can you be going to church? I will wait. My vehicle is not okay. I will repair it. You are forgetting that you were nobody when God gave you the vehicle. So those things is not helping our relationship. Are not helping our relationship at all with God. It destroys our relationship with the more. And that is the period and time you should have honored God before men. Your situation should be the more reason you should honor God before men. Tell your neighbor. Yes, a time to honor God the more before men. You honor God. You say Jesus must be honored. Must be honored. Jesus must be honored in my life. That is the more reason you should honor God. It's not when breakthrough, business, cars, have breakthrough, you begin to say, hey, Jesus is the one that do it for me. No. A time that is not convenient for you, if you give it to God, that is a time you are very, very, very tired and you are just sleeping. You can just get up off the bed and be on your knee and pray. Wow. It's very dear to God. But you always give God your convenient time. The time you do not need, these are the time you give to God. Time you do not need, like I was saying last time, that if you receive a phone call now, hello, hello, that business you have been waiting for, the money has been cashed, we are waiting for you in the bank, almost $300 million. You would call Usher, please, where is the lavatory? So I'm pressed. Usher will say, what do you mean? And Usher don't want to, if you say, where is lavatory? Usher will say, hold on. Please, I'm pressed. Usher will not want you to mess up in the church. He will say, okay, let's go. He said, okay, thank you. You will not hold it till you get to the lavatory and you tell Usher, don't worry, you can go. After you see Usher have gone, you just join, you get inside the vehicle. You say, yes, I'll come and give testimony. Hallelujah. So Jesus loved you. Honor him before men. Honor him before men. The time, hard time, is the best time to honor God greatly before men. Because men will be looking at you, say, it has happened to your friend, you. Your friend, they have ejected him, they have sacked him. Or your enemy in your working place, they realize that they have given you a sack letter. They want to wait to see your reaction. That is when they want to know whether you are a Christian or not. So the way you will receive that sack letter, your attitude towards it will determine whether you are a Christian or not. Not when breakthrough comes. Anybody can jubilate when miracle happen, but not everyone can say thank you Jesus before miracle. Are you with me?
Yes.
When someone is on the way, and we are about to pray for the person on the way, it's not everyone who will say thank you Jesus before we pray and begin to say thank you Jesus before that prayer. But when we pray for the person on the way and the rise, everyone will jubilate. Anyone can shout after a miracle, but not everyone can shout thank you Jesus before that miracle. I want you to begin to shout thank you Jesus before miracle. Tell your neighbor, thank you Jesus before miracle. I can hear you. I can hear you. Can you hear what I'm saying? Can you hear what I'm saying? Can you hear what I'm saying? You are not even answering me. Thank you. Listen once again. When someone lying in a coma, you remember what happened to Lazarus? When Jesus approached the situation, why the thousands were watching to see what will happen next. They were expecting our Savior to join them crying, because people were crying. He was saying, Jesus just entered and looked at them, and they were expecting, he has come, let's see what you want to do. He said, Father, I thank you, because you have been answering me, and I know you will answer me, and I know you will continue to answer me. You know, people around there that were crying, they say, what is happening to this man? We are crying, somebody is dead. We are asking you to come and raise the dead, and you are thanking God, because thanking him because the man died, it must be the one that killed him. He said, thank you Lord, because you have been answered my prayer, and I know at this moment you will not disappoint me. So now I want you today to John, Christian, true Christian, before miracle, thank you, Jesus. You have answered me. And remember the one he has done in the past. And remember the one, if he could do it yesterday, he can still do it today. Why can't you thank him for yesterday? And also say, I know if he could do it for me yesterday, I know you will do it now. I want to thank you before prayer. And stop thanking after miracle. Join the people that thanking Jesus before miracle, not after miracle. After miracle has happened. Tell your neighbor, join Christian that thank Jesus after miracle has happened, before the miracle happened, not after the miracle has happened. You should learn this. This is the life of Christian. When you are given a sack letter and they have written it down, your company partner, the worker, all of them know that you are coming to receive your partner, your letter, they'll say, the man is a Christian, but let us see what will happen today. They say, but the man is a Christian, this kind of news, we don't know how to deliver it. They have messed up your Christian life. They mess up your Christian life. People, you say, ah, but the man is a Christian, but we don't know how to deliver this message. But he's a Christian, but we don't know how to deliver this message. They should know how to deliver it because they should know you're a Christian. Not only when the goings are good, you are a Christian when the goings are tough. Tell your neighbor, I'm not only a Christian when the goings are good, I'm a Christian when good goings are tough. Tell your neighbor. Tell your neighbor once again. I can't hear you. Tell your neighbor. Tell your neighbor. Yes. But today, Christianity is all about miracle. Hey, good, when the goings are good. Our working with the law is both good and hard time. You should not only be a Christian when the goings are good. Remember Job. You should be a Christian when goings are tough. Then, before miracle happen, you should be able to say, thank you, Lord, and remember the one he has done yesterday. And if he could do it yesterday, he can do it now. Not when miracle happen, you say thank you and begin to jump. People should know you. People should not wait and say, we don't know how to deliver this message. But it's a Christian, but we don't know how to deliver the message. And begin to look for somebody to come and deliver the message. When you are about to receive maybe a sack letter, whatever, your colleague are waiting to see your reaction. Suddenly, given you look at it and say, thank you, Jesus. God is still saying something. What can some God say when you are receiving a sack letter? There is a promotion in sack letter. 99% of the great people today all over the world, it was the sack letter that promoted them to that. Listen, 99% of the great, the richest in the world today, most powerful people in the world today, you talk about, you mention, you want to be like. Ask them, they will tell you that it was sack letter they received that opened the way for them. Don't forget our relationship in the past. Vividly, if I may remind you, 5 years ago, 99% of people here today, in the assembly here today, 99%. Would not want to hear the name TB Joshua 5 years ago. I repeat again. 5 years ago, 99% of congregation here today would not want to hear the name TB Joshua or associate themselves with that name, or Twins to Emmanuel TV and Wash, because they see it as a demonic channel 5 years ago. But today, because I honor God why you are rebuking me, I honor God why you hate me. Here you are today. Here you are today. Someone you did not want to associate yourself with in the past has now become your best, if not your mentor. If you must be a friend of God, your character must be tested. Tell your neighbor, if you must be a friend of God, your character must be tested. Not just tests in a rare situation. You know what I mean by rare? R-E-A-L. Not uncommon situation. Situation that only God can get you out of it. Oh my God. If I'm talking to you, let me hear you. If I'm talking to you, let me hear you. Not just common situation that when it happens you can run to people, help me. They will help you because they have passed through it before. But real situation are situation that only God can get you out of it. Jesus must be honored. Yes, this led many to join secret society when they are in a situation, when the character is being tested, when the test comes, many run to join court. When character being tested, many join secret society. When character being tested, many run to the wall for refuge. Tell your neighbor, your character must be tested. Tell your neighbor. I can't hear you. The nature of test could be poverty, could be sickness, could be temptation, could be affliction. Any nasty thing foolish thing. When your character was being tested, where were you? Where did you run to? Is it that brought the product, what we are seeing today? Remember in the past, David said, even though I pass through the valley of what? I fear no what? Because who? What is your shadow of death? What is your shadow of death? When your character is being tested, you run to people of the world. You join court, secret society. You run hater skater, looking for God's father. Your character will not be, there is nothing that will stop people from testing your character until you leave this world. Your character will continue to be tested. This is what Bible means by we are in the war, but we are not part of them. We are a stranger. If you think you have arrived now, if you fail the last test, the day you leave this, you will depart from this world. If you fail the last test, you are going to hell. So therefore, the first can be the last, and the last can be the first. Don't rejoice. It's not yet over. So I bless you in his name. Viewers, thank you, thank you, thank you.